Wilson, thank you for being here. You know, as we just shared a little bit of your personal life, that you came from a situation of extreme oppression, a structural oppression that it was hard to break free from. You yourself broke through from it. But could you tell us a little bit about what was so difficult, you know, when you could break through? Why are others not able to break through? And what was the experience of your elder brother and your parents who had to work as scavengers?
This is a great opportunity to explain, but many times I explained about my personal, how it is. But I want to make it again one more point, that it is a very difficult, once you know that you are untouchable in this country, to again to live. Once you just know that you are untouchable, that itself makes a kind of a completely disaster-like. So again, gaining any kind of a confident is it is like a miracle. One has to struggle too much. It is not enough to actually win over in one lifetime. Such a problem is an untouchability, but we never actually taken that as so serious. Just we think about Article 17 says untouchability prohibition, but we never feel that we are all equal at all. We do fight for the inequality, but we have no concept of we are all equal. If we felt that we are all equal, and I no need to come here and again repeatedly to talk about the scavenging. What is scavenging, which we are all thinking about? We are thinking about the just sweeping all other things. And we are thinking, no, I am talking about making another human being to clean the human excreta by hand. It is happening everywhere in the country. The day when we are sitting and talking, 1.6 lakh women, today morning also they have cleaned. And it is 5,000 years we are cleaning. And when you get to know that, I also belong to this, that is in a kind of a very difficult to accept. Even if you don't accept, your life is just miserable.
So, Wilson, you know, as I said in the beginning, that India has a lot of progressive legislation. Right at the moment of its birth, we enshrine the idea of equal citizenship. There is a lot of progressive legislation around Dalits, even for manual scavenging and sewage workers. It has been repeatedly banned in 93 and then again in 2013. It was further enhanced in 2016. Why is this practice still prevalent? You know, when it is legislated against, it's banned. Why are people still dying in the sewage holes of India?
The sensitivity of the citizens in the country is really very questionable. If I say that openly, it is very difficult to one can understand or digest that, but it is a fact. We just banned in 1993. We said that we have prohibited the practice. 2003, we went to the court. Till 10 years, we have done nothing. Even we have not ratified the act in the assemblies. Even you ratify that, who has to punish who? We have not decided. Then everything court has to say. Then who went and who challenged? We have almost like a 650 districts. So the district magistrate has to punish the person who engages or employs the manual scavenger. But all these years till to date, we have not punished even a single person. Not even a single person. We have the courts, we have the police stations, we have the ministers, we have everything in this country. But we have not even punished even a single person, at least a single moment in across the country. The law will be there, the people will be carrying, the ministries will come and ministries will go, elections will come, elections will go. But the things will not change. They remain the same. We go to the court. What the court will ask? The court will ask you to produce the evidences. What is evidence? Evidence is that you have to click the photograph when women is cleaning. So for me in my life, the very, very painful is